up guys, it's Chris here. I now make videos every single Monday and Wednesday and a lot of times in between. I make videos on NFTs and crypto and specifically VB and eCoin related videos. If that's something that interests you, please consider hitting the subscribe button down below, it helped me out a lot. Also, if this video benefits you in any sort of way, I'd appreciate it if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithms. Thanks a lot. In this video, I'm going to be going over the MTL or the money transfer license and how it could possibly affect the VB marketplace. I'm going to give some pros and some cons and give a very small opinion at the end. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So this money transfer license is going to allow users to finally get their gems and bring it back to their currency. And there's going to be a lot of different currencies they can convert it to, but at the end of the day, they will be able to get their money out of the app. This is something that a lot of early users and people have been anticipating for quite a while. And although there's been kind of loose dates, we definitely know we are closer than we were before. In the last VB AMA, I actually wasn't able to make it, but they always do a recap over Twitter, and they said it like this. MTL, the main work is all done on our end. Didn't want to roll out big updates before Disney or DCon happened to avoid any issues. We will push this live into the public, build of the app, roll out beta testers, then roll out to the public shortly thereafter. So they said it's done. You know, it's ready to go, and they're going to start sending it out soon. And we also see, and I think this is going to be a good thing, that's going to be rolling out in phases. And we've known this for a while. It's going to be rolling out for beta testers, then roll out to the rest of the public. Well, there's been a lot of talk recently over how this is going to affect the market. Some people think it's going to affect the market in a negative way. And some people feel that it's going to impact the market in a positive way. So let's take a look at both of those. All right, so let's start with the positive effects of MTL. I'm going to use a Facebook post that was shared with me by, I don't know for sure if I'm saying this name right, but Lucas. It's from the VB Collectibles Facebook page, and he provides some good insight. I'm not going to go into detail about one, but basically his first argument is KYC. So after VB is actually going to be needing, you know, proof of identity in order to cash out. So not everybody's going to provide that and cash out immediately. Two, cashing out will be a taxable event that you will not be able to avoid. Yeah, this is very true. So once you're able to get your gems back into your own fiat, then it depends on where you're at, of course. But like, I'm in the US and that will be a taxable event that I can't avoid. So, I mean, that's very true what he's saying. And that's something that a lot of people are overlooking, especially when they're doing a lot of big flips consistently. Number three, people who really want to sell their gems are already doing this here and on Telegram through crypto, which is less complicated in the case of taxes. I kind of disagree with this point because honestly, right now, if you're cashing out, you're still not getting the total value of your gems. So a gem should be, you know, 1 to 1 for the dollar, but it's just simply not right now. Right now, if I had 100 gems and I wanted to convert that to dollars, somebody would probably give me like $70 for those 100 gems. That's just the way it is. You know, the benefit to them being able to avoid fees, you're probably just not going to get a 1-to-1 right now. So I do see people waiting on that 1-to-1 aspect, especially with a larger amount of gems. It would just make sense. Also, when you do take it out, regardless of whether somebody's sending it to you or not, it is still a taxable event. So I'm not fully on board with number three. Number four is super interesting. It will all depend on what circumstances this is done. If it happens after we are on Immutable X and after NFT to OMI, I do not see it having any negative impact as sellouts will be eaten by newcomers. If this happens as an X and NFT to OMI, we will see a dip that may last until above is put into place. So for this aspect, again, I kind of agree. Specifically, I agree more on the NFT to OMI because I think that's going to be a big deal. There's a lot of whales with a lot of OMI, and once they're able to just easily buy it with their OMI, I do see them, you know, scooping up a lot of floors. I made a separate video on IMX and you guys can go watch it. I think it's a great resource for this, but I definitely don't think IMX is going to introduce us immediately to the user base that we need. Again, referencing my video, there's around like 7,000 to 10,000 wallets on there. Not a lot of volume right now in comparison. So yes, eventually IMX will give us more volume and that will help with everything, but I don't think it's going to be right away. But I also do agree that with people cashing out, there are all, and this is another positive attribute to it, there's also going to be a lot of newcomers. How many people do you know personally that you've mentioned VB to, and one of the first things that they ask you is, well, how do I cash out? And then you try to explain to them, well, you can't, we're waiting on the MTL, and you know, when is that gonna happen? Hashtag soon. So we all know at least one person that would be more likely to jump on board on VB if the MTL was already in place. So I do think a lot of users are going to get replaced with new users, you know, users that are leaving the app and new users that are coming into the app. But that being said, those are a lot of positive attributes that could come along with MTL. Let's take a look at some of the negative. Not really a huge deal, but we did have some things happen recently. Like, I don't know if you will be able to see this because my camera doesn't want to automatically focus on it, but this is the Walt statue. The Walt statue, as of a couple days ago, almost hit a 12K floor. Today, it dropped to a 7.5K floor. There is various reasons of why this happened, but some of them really do just have to do with FUD. We had some very small events happen in the past few days, and if you're involved with the Twitter spaces or Discord or whatever, you're probably familiar with them. Now, I'm not pointing any fingers at anyone or anything, and honestly, at the end of the day, I really don't care. My point of even bringing this up is the community floors do fall a bit due to FUD. What do you think is going to happen when we do officially find out that we are 1 week away from it? I think it's unfair to assume that people who have been here for nearly a year don't deserve to cash out, or also that they're not going to cash out at least some. Maybe some will cash out their initial investment, that way they can let the rest ride. Maybe some won't cash out at all, and maybe some will cash out their entire investment. That is definitely their decision. It is up to the community's decision and the holder's decision to decide what's going to happen to the floors. But even just a little bit of FUD has caused the floors to like kind of shake a little bit, then I do see how people would think that something like MTL could really cause a disruption on floor. So what do you do about it? You make your own decisions on how you're going to approach it and what you think it's going to do. Because at the end of the day, we don't know. My game plan personally is just like the same for the gem squeeze. I said this before the gem squeeze and I stuck to my game plan. I want to keep liquid at hand. I want to keep some gems at hand. If there is a window of the floors dropping between MTL and it getting scooped up by new users, or MTL and it getting scooped up by wells, or MTL and it never getting scooped up, because at the end of the day, I'm going to be okay with my decision. I am at the level of confidence in my investments to where I'm okay if I sell something and it moons, or I'm okay if I buy something and it doesn't go up. That's the way that I am right now. So personally, yes, I'm going to keep liquid just in case we do see a dip during MTL. If we don't see a dip, I'll use those gems for other things. At the end of the day, that's how it is. I hope this video brought some kind of benefit to you. I hope that I was able to kind of show both sides. I know I did show more pros than cons. I do want to say that the scales are almost even in my opinion. Although we have many more pros than cons, the one con is that the cashing out might lead to FUD in the community, and that in the community could hurt the floor. But at the end of the day, who really knows? I hope you make good decisions. I really want us all to win. I want these VV collectibles to go up constantly and in the future. I want OMI to go up. I'm invested in both. I'm passionate about both. I'm a collector and an investor. It's in my best interest that both go up. So it's up to everyone to see how this does, and I'm along for the ride. So thank you guys, and until next time.